The Deputy Prime Minister has just wrapped up a meeting with the leader of the Solomon Islands tonight, committing to deepen security cooperation. Richard Marles also visited Australian personnel whose stay in Honiara may be extended.
A warm welcome to the humid tropics of Honiara.
It's great to be back.
The Deputy Prime Minister's visit sending a signal to a close Pacific neighbour which recently looked elsewhere to forge security ties.
We're still concerned about the wide-ranging security pact that Solomon signed with China.
Keen to stress what Australia has to offer, Richard Marles sat down for talks with the Solomon's PM late this afternoon. Manase Sogavare has repeatedly assured the government Australia is their partner of choice over Beijing, but experts say actions would speak louder.
We would like to see some sort of de facto winding back of that security pact with China.
Particularly because the deal could allow Beijing to establish a military base in our backyard, a red line for Australia and one Sogavare has vowed won't be crossed.
Evidence of our investment in the Solomons is clear right here. These are some of the 300 Defence Force troops and Federal Police on the ground, shoring up internal stability and security.
The Solomon Islands is front and centre in terms of how we relate to the world and how we relate to our region, and your being here is such an important part of that.
Their deployment during a period of unrest in 2021 is due to wrap up in December, but if the Solomons agree, the mission will likely be extended.
Tomorrow, the Deputy Prime Minister will visit some Australian-funded projects, including accommodation for the Pacific Games in November. But China has bankrolled an entire stadium complex here in Honiara, showing just how competitive the race for influence is.